afternoon, everyone. My name is Catherine. I'll be your webinar facilitator today. At this time, I'd like to welcome you to the It's a New Year, Did You Know? It's Time to Start Optimizing for Air Conditioning Services webinar. All lines are currently on mute to prevent any background noise. If you have any questions during the presentation, please submit them through the questions area on your dashboard to be answered at the conclusion of the webinar. I'd like to turn the webinar over to Jennifer Bagley, CEO of CI Web Group. Jennifer is one of our premier providers. Jennifer, you may now begin the webinar.
Thank you very much. I appreciate you, and I appreciate everybody taking time out of the middle of your day to join this webinar. You guys are in for a treat today. We are going to focus on how to grow your business in your cooling season. So you're probably freezing right now wherever you are. Or at least you've got a chill in the air. So you might be wondering why I've got spring flowers on here, and I should put a big sunshine up there because that's what this is about. We are going to concentrate on the things you should be doing right now. And depending on when you're watching this, this is, what are we in, January of 2015, and you guys have got to be prepping right now for your cooling season for summer, especially when it comes to search engine optimization. So this lovely little chart, I think I drew it on a napkin one day, is essentially outlining how to grow your business digitally. Right hand side, lead generation, that's what's going to make your phone ring. Having a killer, perfectly designed website, having consistent content frequently, and getting that content ranked on page one of Google organically, which is this area over here. And that takes a lot to get that to happen. But getting onto page one of Google, sitting in a position one, position two, or three, look at this, you've got around 60% of your total conversions are happening in these top three slots. Four and five are pulling in the ranks. And anything under the top five slots in Google is really down kind of in the weeds. So we got to get you into this position. This is the organic version. This is the pay-per-click version. This can happen overnight. This takes time. Because this takes time, if you don't start putting all of these things in place right now, and some of you, if you're in Texas, for example, you guys, it's going to get hot soon. That's going to, I think you have what, 3 months of winter-ish, and then boom, you go straight cold to hot. And so you technically should have been starting in November around Christmas time or before, November through December. So you might be a little bit behind the game, which is going to modify your strategy slightly, but you're going to at least have the basic details to figure out what you should be doing and why it's so important to get started right now. In order for this process, this lead generation process to take place, there's a lot of work to do. So this side, everything is interconnected, which, you know, a lot of HVAC clients, they struggle because you're working with three, four, and five different vendors. They're, you know, really throwing stuff against the wall, seeing what's going to stick. You guys have salespeople coming into your office every single day, calling you consistently. Hey, sign up for Yodel pages. Hey, sign up for Yodel. Hey, sign up for Yodel. All of these things, and you don't know what to do. So you just start throwing money at the best salesperson's activities to try and see if you can get some results. No one is coordinating all of these different companies' efforts. Nothing's actually being leveraged. No real results are really being seen because there's not a comprehensive plan or strategy, and there's limited, if any, collaboration in between these different groups. So you got to get it under one house. And this is, you know, I'm a business owner. I'm an entrepreneur. So I tend to think like an entrepreneur should think, how to run a business. You have operations and logistics and products and people and trucks and insurance, and you have customers and past clients and current clients and prospects. And all of these things have to be part of what's incorporated into your marketing strategy. When you get into the marketing environment, I know because I've got 60 full-time people around the world, throughout the United States, from Seattle, Washington, to Texas, to New York, through different countries overseas, and these guys are subject matter experts. So our design team, they believe everything they do is uno first, most important. Our development team believes what they do is most important, and rightfully so. Our SEO guys think that their recommendations are most important. Our social media team, same thing. So this team right here of people, they need to have someone that understands business, and I'm known as a growth hacker. They need to know and have somebody prioritizing all of their efforts. So when you're you know, segregating all of your services, or you don't have that middleman that can prioritize the needs amongst all these different people, you wind up getting less results. So that being said, what are the goals of this presentation? What should most of your goals be? And I say that because there's some of you that are in a position where you've done what you need to do to have a pretty full plate. Your techs are busy, your trucks are not sitting in a parking lot, and you really need to focus on something different, which is going to be streamlining operations in order to become more efficient so you have higher margins and less costs, more time, less costs. That we're going to address that. Actually, I think the next presentation in February is really focused on automation strategies to help you become more operationally efficient, which everybody should concentrate on that. For this one, we are definitely going to focus on how do we increase visibility. You guys are not shy of having potential customers, i.e. homeowners, business owners, that have a need for your services. Whether they have children with allergies and they can't figure out how to get the air in their house clean to reduce the allergy issues, whether they have a broken air conditioner, whether they just bought a new house and that house has an air conditioning system or a furnace in it that is 12 years old and they know it needs replaced, or their energy bills are too high, there are plenty of opportunities out there. The game is real simple. We got to make sure that when they are looking for a solution to whatever their problem is, that you're an option. It's that simple. So there's a lot of activities that are real tough, and that's hard. You know, if you send a print mailer, you have to hit, like, to the millisecond the right family at the right time, and you have to catch somebody who doesn't go to the mailbox, grab their mail, throw out all the junk mail without giving it even an eyeball, or drop it in the fire to start their fire that night. So in the digital world, it's a little bit easier. My guess is you're going about your normal life. You're at a ball game, you're at the movies, you are in a mall, you're at a restaurant. You see people living on their cell phones. The way they search for service providers is definitely changing. Social media, local listings, directories, Google, the internet, whether they're talking to Siri and saying, hey, Siri, give me I need an HVAC company in blank, wherever the location is. Or they're on their watch. They're on their watch, a 1-inch by 1-inch watch, and they hold down the little side button and say, AC repair in blank, or can you get me an AC repair company in blank, and so forth. So in order to increase your visibility, we've got to get you in front of your prospects where they are looking already. Don't try and reinvent the wheel. Even if your personal preferences on how you would go about finding a roofer or a contractor or a pool installation company or tickets for a movie are different, don't worry about your own personal preferences, because I promise you, based on data and experience and just look around as you're out and about, you're going to notice that the internet is where you need to sit and reside, and you're going to have to do a little bit of work to get there. So more visibility you have, the more traffic you have, the better your website is optimized for conversions, the more potential leads you guys are going to get. If you have a website that is not designed properly, don't worry about this presentation, because we need to attend the website design and conversions presentations. We need to focus on that first. Otherwise, you could be spending money driving them to your website only for them to get there and feel like, this is not really a professional site, or I can't figure out who you are, what you do, or I don't know if this is really what I'm looking for. I don't know if you service my area. I try to click the little phone number at the top of your site. It doesn't click the call. Whatever all the frustrating things are that will turn your traffic away, not convert, and have you spending money with no results. So we have to take care of that. More leads you get, the more times you get to go sit in somebody's living room and present. That's, you know, from the guys that we work with, I mean, that's what you need. You need to be able to get into somebody's home. And that's what this is about. Once you're in their home, you have an opportunity to increase revenue. Once you have a new client, you have an opportunity to increase your retention, repeat business, and referral business, which is why you can never, never, never neglect your current and past client base. So that is your number one asset and always should be treated as such. So there has to be very specific marketing activities that are put into place for existing and past clients. And we'll talk more about that in more presentations. So bottom line, it's time for cooling. I know you're cold right now, but we've got to get ready for the air conditioning season. These are the things that we're going to concentrate on. You've got seven basics. These are really kind of the fundamentals: SEO, content, promotions, graphics, backlinks, social, and local. All of this being said, only if you have the perfect website in place to be able to take advantage of the activity that can come from these things. So organic SEO, higher rankings equals higher visibility. Higher visibility equals higher sales. The more sales you have, the more money you're making. Hopefully, that's profitable business as well. Now, that being said, this is the cool part. Digital marketing, we have to break it down and get out all the complexities because it's really complicated. However, it's not complicated at all. So with that kind of oxymoron, I want you to think about search engine optimization or online marketing versus offline marketing. I want you to compare this. So if you're sitting in somebody's living room or at their dining room table and you're having a conversation, you guys are presenting to them. So number one, you're going to be talking. Talking offline is content online. What do both of these things mean to either Google online, people offline, is that you're current. Hopefully you're using phrases that make sense to the consumer's needs. So in the middle of winter, you're not going to be talking about air conditioning repair. You're going to be talking about furnace repair, furnace installation, furnace replacement, furnace maintenance, furnace tune-ups, and so forth. In the middle of summer, you're going to be using content, language, talking, key phrases that are related to air conditioning, AC, air conditioner, air conditioning. Google wants the exact same thing. If you stop talking, if you walk into somebody's house and you sit down and you just blink, blink, and you don't say anything, you're probably not going to get the business. The same exact thing applies to your website. If your website is no different than you sitting at the table and it just sits there, blink, blink, and it doesn't say anything. It's not new. It's not fresh. It doesn't address their issues. It's confusing. If you have a page on your website called services and somebody comes to your site and they're like, home, about, services, FAQ, contact us. Services is as about as valuable as blink, blink. Google doesn't know what that is. You can't walk in and talk to a client and say, hey, I've got services. I got services. It's not going to get you anywhere. So we have to really think about what are the exact phrases that consumers are looking for? What do they want to hear? What are they typing into Google? What are they saying to their cell phone? What are they saying to their watch? And then present your website as a solution. So this addresses two things. Google cares about, are you current? That's the frequency of new content being posted on your website. Offline, it's your presentation skills as far as talking. Are you relative? That's the content, the phrases and the wording that's inside the content. Does it make sense? Is it literal? Is it can it be filed into the right drawer? The third thing that's most critical is, are you trusted? So one of the questions you have consumers ask you on a regular basis, I'm sure, is, do you have any reviews? Do you have any testimonials? Do you have any endorsements? Do you have any clients in my neighborhood that you've installed new equipment for? And can I see them? Well, Google wants the exact same thing. It wants to know, do other people trust you? But it can't talk to people. So the only way Google knows your website is trusted, or that particular page specifically is trusted, is if you have backlinks, reviews, local listing reviews, social media engagement from real people. So the greater your backlinks, the greater and better your reviews are, the more reviews you have on local business directories, the more engagement you have on your social media site, that's how Google determines, can I trust this page, your voice, on your website? Which technically your website should be the best salesperson you've ever had. In fact, if you were to take the same salary you would pay one full-time employee, one FTE, and apply it to your digital marketing, I promise you, your website is going to perform, far outperform what you could do through one person, because it doesn't sleep, it doesn't eat, it doesn't have sick days, it doesn't go on vacation, doesn't require insurance. It will work for you forever, regardless of anything, including natural disasters. And I think there's probably an exception to that, but it takes time. So no different than if you just start your business and you don't have any clients yet, you don't have any endorsements yet, or you've been in business and you have lacked trying to get reviews from your clients. It's going to take a minute to get this done, but the bottom line is the same concept as far as what it takes to sell offline is the exact same thing that it takes online, even with all of these complicated acronyms and words and whatnot that everybody uses. So, that being said, we have to identify what people are looking for. There are some real basics that we know across the nation, and it doesn't matter where you are. AC, air conditioner, air conditioning. I'm going to come back to cooling. Ductless AC, air filters, whole house filtration system. And you can go to Google, type in AC repair, and you can scroll all the way down to the bottom of Google, and it's going to have something called LSIs, latency, syntax, something. Those are recommendations. Those recommendations are based on how people actually search. So there's more ideas, but essentially you want to have an SEO engineer and analyst go through and do this evaluation for you. There are some differences depending where you're at. If you're in a melting pot city like Texas, then people refer to heaters as heater and furnace. If you're in New York, you have boilers and you got oil to gas conversions. There's a whole bunch of different things. You may have propane versus electric versus gas and so forth. So there are very, very different indices across different locations. So you really need to have an engineer that does this. Also, you've got to remember, you guys are subject matter experts. I put cooling on here just as a conversation piece. Cooling is an action. You guys use it heavily in your industry, but it's an industry term that consumers rarely search for. They don't say cooling repair, but I see a ton of websites that say heating and cooling repair. Cooling is an action, not a system, not a thing. So that's not usually what people look for. So, but it's definitely better than our services. So all of those phrases have different variations. The variations are going to include something like maintenance, tune-up, service, repair, audit, emergency, efficiency, cost, estimate, and so forth. Equipment, I could keep going. They're also going to have geolocations. So that's going to be by the physical location that they are in, whether it's a city, community, town, if it's rural or if it's urban, very, very different searches. If you're sitting in the middle of Los Angeles, that is going to be an extremely complicated search phrase with a high competition. So you're going to get out of Los Angeles and start looking at what are the individual neighborhoods called that are in that area or small suburbs of Los Angeles that you can focus on. Same thing with a Seattle or a New York. You got to dive into, in Seattle, it would be West Seattle, Ballard, Fremont, you'd be getting into the actual Queen Anne, you'd be getting into those neighborhoods. That being said, the next thing is really understanding timing. You know, this is our methodology based on our experience and our results. So part of the analysis that has to be done and you guys have to walk into with a good understanding is every phrase has a different set of competitors. Not the competitor down the street, not the one staring at you, not the one driving the pink truck that makes you crazy every time you see it. Digital competitors are very different. Digital competitors are in the form of pages. So So if I go to Google and I type in AC repair, we'll go Riverside, California, since it auto popped up. So for this particular phrase, variation, and geolocation, notice there's three things here. This is the phrase, this is the variation, this is the location, or geo. There is 365,000 competitive pages in this drawer. That's what digital marketers mean by competition. They're not talking about Joe from, you know, Blue Heating and Air. I don't know Joe from Blue Heating and Air. So, okay, so in order for you to make any money, going back to one of those first slides, when I say be in that top five, I mean, that's where everything's happening. If you're paying for pay-per-click, you're going to be sitting in this area and this area. Absolutely, incredibly important. This presentation is not about that, but you absolutely need to do this, and this is something that you can get more immediate results on. Underneath that, you have Google Business Listing. You better have a Google Business Listing. It is free. You need it. It is really important, and you need this specifically for the location that you have a physical address. So that's going to put you on the map, literally. Everyone's map. Every single person that owns a cell phone has Google Maps on their phone, and all of these are showing up because of the Google Business Listing. Underneath that, you have search engine optimized results. These are the organic search engine results, and there's always going to be 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, always 10. Here's where the money is. So this is one of our clients sitting in position two. We also have his business listing sitting in position one. As we scroll down, we have another one of our clients that we're pulling up the ranks, trying to get him up here to bump this guy down a little bit, and so forth. So this is where conversions take place. If you're sitting anywhere else, you're not. The phone's not ringing, promise. So this area, if I change this and I say, let's go Los Angeles. Remember, there was 345,000 competitive pages. You need to be number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6 of 345,000 for that search. For this search, AC Repair Los Angeles, there are 20 million competitive pages. 20 million. So in order to get you an interior page on your website to show up for in the top six spots, the top three spots, or number one of 20 million, it's a lot more work, a lot more time, a lot more effort, and a lot more opportunity. So the larger your competitive pages are, your competition, typically it's also going to equal a higher population, which means more people in houses and businesses that need your services. So is it worth it to try and go after something like this? Yes, if you're willing to invest potentially for a year or longer before you get there, depending on a lot of different factors. So that being said, when you guys are pulling together your SEO plan, the reason that it is, I think we're in January, and we're talking about air conditioning, is because you need to have 12 months, 6 months, or at a minimum, 3 months, depending on the competition for the phrases and the locations and the variations that you want to go after. You have to have that time. There's no way to just blink and go, ha, I'm number one of 20 million, or I'm number one of 500,000, or I'm number one of 250,000. Overnight, it's not going to happen. There are so many factors. I would absolutely bore you, and you would hate my presentation if I told you what's all involved. So we got to agree on this together. We've got to do the competition analysis. We have to understand the timing, and you really have to, you know, come to the table with kind of a risk tolerance. Is how much are you willing to invest into something that's much more difficult for how long before you see a return on investment, versus what percent of your dollars do you need to invest into something that you can get an immediate turnaround like pay-per-click, or a quick turnaround like a low competition key phrase, or a medium, and so forth. And that's got to be part of your planning process up front. So those timelines, those are not industry timelines. Those are our timelines based on our experience in doing this in the HVAC industry since 2006. Disclaimers. So all things considered, my timing estimates that I gave you above, there are some disclaimers. If you have one or more issues that I have on this list of 12 going on that may not be able to be found until month 2, 3, or 4 of working, then it could potentially take longer because there's other activities that are going to have to take place to fix it. So number one, you need to have a domain name in good standing with Google for 2 years. So if you're brand new, you're a startup, you just bought your domain name, or you're an existing client, or excuse me, an existing company, you've got 22 years in the business and you just decide you don't like your domain name anymore, you want something short and sweet, think twice before you just go out and purchase a brand new domain name, because in Google's eyes, no matter how many years you've been in business, you are an infant and you have to earn the right to be trusted. So don't take it lightly. There's a whole bunch of things I can do to get you ahead of the game, compress time, and get you results faster. Something I cannot do, I cannot buy you time. If you've got 20 years history, 10 years history, 5 years history, 3 years history, 2 years history with your domain name in good standing with Google, that's worth a lot. It's worth a lot. So we can give you other options. Your domain name is registered for at least 2 years or greater, so when it comes up and it's for renewal, number one, hopefully you never let your web company purchase your domain name for you. Hopefully you own your domain name. It's in your own GoDaddy account or whatever domain registrar. You own it, and when it comes up for renewal, don't pick 1 year. Always pick 2 to 5 years or greater. Because that's one of the things Google's looking at is how long are you going to be around? If you only pick 1 year, you may be a fly-by-night. Those are often the same guys that are also building websites that are scam sites, taking money, closing the site down, building a new one, running with the money, and continuing to do that over and over again. So I know that's not your intention, but you want to make sure you've got time. We have to make sure your URL is not blacklisted, graylisted, or in violation of any Google's terms, which means your website needs to be designed per Google's guidelines and you don't have any crazy SEO companies breaking Google's rules and putting your website in jail, which is graylist or blacklist. All right, your website is not, the technology is not older than 2 years. Yes, you got to have a new website every 2 years. And I promise you, so the process of having a website done, totally not fun. We build hundreds of them. I'm not going to say it's not an exciting process, right? It's rather complicated. No different than you have to have a new website every 2 years to make sure you're in compliance with all of Google's new guidelines, which change every single month. You guys also have to have a website that performs based on the technology that your homeowners and business owners and prospects and customers are using. There are 150 different shapes of devices just in one product line for cell phones. We've got a client that does mobile devices. The sizes. Your website has to work on every single size mobile device. Now, your website has to work on a 1 inch by 1 inch or 1.5 inch or 1.25 inch by 1.25 inch watch, a wearable device, and I promise you, oh my gosh, that's what we're prepping for now. And we're moving into virtual reality environments. Again, totally different. So you cannot have an old website, and if you had Bob build your website a year ago, don't have Bob rebuild it unless Bob seriously got some good experience under his belt. Okay, so website is free of malware or viruses. You're meeting the minimum guidelines for content posting. Remember when I was talking about talking? If you stop talking, you stop selling. Same thing online. You stop posting new blog content on your website and off your website for backlinks, then you're not meeting the Google's minimum guidelines for content posting. You stop talking. Also, invest in pay-per-click, least, bare minimum, $20 a day with Google. That way you get on the pet list, which essentially Google gives preferential treatment to those who are investing in pay-per-click. So just by investing in PPC, you now are getting a boost in your SEO rankings because of that. Google trusts you more for its own personal reasons, I'll say. Okay, so top 50 local business listings are accurate and free of errors. I have seen 101 situations where you guys have listings that have wrong addresses, wrong phone numbers. You have an ex phone number who's now selling for a different company next to your name. Everything not optimized. The more discombobulated, I love that word, you are online throughout all these local listings, the more Google is going to not trust your website. If it can't figure out actually what the real data is, inconsistencies can kill you. So you got to get that fixed on your social media sites, local listings, business directories, everything. And it's not expensive. It's not expensive. Don't do it yourself. That's crazy. All right, frequency of posting on one or more social media accounts with active engagement, very important. Do other people trust you? That has to do with your social metasphere. You have more positive reviews on Google than negative ones. Notice I didn't say Home Advisor. If you're spending all your time trying to get Home Advisor reviews or Angie's List reviews, and the only way somebody can see the reviews is if they pay for a subscription or join their membership and it's sitting behind a firewall where they have to log in to see it, that doesn't have a lot of value for you. We want leveraged reviews. So in the digital space, Google is God. You want to get your reviews on Google. The more you have, the more places you're going to show up. Your pay-per-click is going to perform better. You're going to show up for your local searches in Google's Maps accounts, and it's going to impact your SEO. If you have more negative reviews than you have positive reviews, we need to be having a different conversation. That is a reputation management issue, and you will probably need to be really focused on reputation management, suppressing those listings, and starting over and fixing whatever operational or personnel issues that are causing negative reviews to happen. They are permanent, they are damaging, and not doing that can cause you to have to redesign, rebrand your entire business. Imagine changing out every single truck rack, every single business card, every single branded t-shirt. No, 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 no. So we got to take care of that. Very, very important. This is why you can never ignore operations, training, and personnel because it absolutely impacts your marketing efforts. So, and your website is constantly being upgraded based on new changing requirements. So, here's the nerd part. When you look at pages on your website, so say you click on a page and it says blankheatingandairconditioning.com/services. That's what I was talking about. You can't sit at the table and say, we've got services. The customer's going to look at you like you're crazy. Google does the exact same thing. You can't sit down at the table and say, we do maintenance. They're like, on what? Where? Same thing with Google. Don't put the page on there that just says maintenance. I can maintain a car, I can maintain my hair color, I can maintain a house, I can maintain your landscaping. You got to be literal, you guys. It's very, very important. And having, you know, these companies build your site or your friends or your family or fools, those are my triple Fs, that's a problem because they don't know your industry to know the phrases. And so they'll go through a set of pages on their home about us, FAQ, our team, and they're all junk pages. Nothing works. So you've got to have really, really smart content, page content. The information architecture needs to be planned based on your products, your services, your locations, consumers' wants, wishes, what they actually look for, and the research that came out of all of the analysis, your tags for your titles, your permalinks, which is everything past the forward slash. So notice this says air conditioning repair, fish kill, New York. That is a permalink. If this said services, junk page. If it said air conditioning, that's okay. If you've got your location inside your description, better yet, if it's a blog post and you can put air conditioning repair, fish kill, New York in there, that's awesome. If it's a services page, you might not want to just narrow it down to one location. So that's what your blog's for. We have to monitor traffic. All of these things, without getting too technical on you, this is what your SEO team should be doing. identifying key phrases, setting up your purple links, your H1 tags, your heading tags, front loading your key phrases inside your content. So the first entry sentence should say something like, providing air conditioning repair services in Fishkill, New York for the past 25 years. Then put in your company name. You want the phrase first, company name, and all the other stuff later. Utilizing that key phrase within the content at least once every 100 words, content minimum of 300 pages, or excuse me, minimum of 300 words per page. Best 1500, minimum 300. You put four lines on there, is it not going to work? Interior links, reporting. Also, when you get really, really good at this, you guys will get to the point where you can create content that's based on the best blank, the guide to blank, HVAC reviews in Fishkill, 2016 top HVAC products, 2016 top air conditioning systems, 2016 best furnaces, 2016 HVAC or heating and air conditioning energy costs. So those are things that people look for on a regular basis as well. Next, promotions. Year one of doing this right, if you have a marketing agency, they should be working in year one very specifically with getting these things outlined. And then you're just building off of it. So they should be designing graphics for these kind of promotions. So you've got discounts, manufacturer rebates, energy company rebates, tax credits, federal tax credits, state, local, high efficiency benefits, energy efficiency benefits, allergy reducers, clean air, and so forth. So you're going to have lots of different kinds of promotions by season. You need to start thinking about what those are. Those need to be part of your pay-per-click strategy, which is your ad campaign or value proposition. They need to be part of your social media, part of your local listings, part of your SEO. And you got to have this stuff done before you roll into summer, and then you're behind the eight ball because you guys are going to get busy. Once you get busy, there's no reaching you and pulling you out of an attic to get this stuff done. So it's got to get done now. Graphics, same thing. Promotions, tips, advice, reviews. If you get a review on a local listing site, don't leave it there. Take that review. What we do is we take that review, we turn it into a pretty graphic like the ones I just showed you, and we take that review and we post it on all the social media sites, local listing sites. We put it on a repeat schedule where we say, post this every 120 days for the next 30 years. Awesome. Get it off your plate, automate it, and leverage that review instead of letting it just sit in one place. You can take that content and put it everywhere. If somebody sends you a handwritten note and it's beautifully written, I'm going to show you an example. One second. So, where do I have that at? So I get handwritten notes from customers. I call them love notes all the time. So they send gifts, they send cards. I'll take a picture of it with my cell phone, send it to my social media guys. They'll send it out on our fan pages, post it on the website. I also take pictures of customers. So if a customer leaves you an amazing review, even if it's a comment on Facebook, take a picture of it. Digitize that. Make it permanent. You've got to be a documentarian for your business, and you don't want to lose things that could be real value-added assets for your business. So I do this constantly. We take photos of customers' responses constantly and just keep them forever. You need these. 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 Very, very, very important. This will do you wonders, okay? So, that's review. Social media, there's around 300 social media sites, 150 of them. You need to at least own your handle. So, here's the challenge. Right now, I'm still debating with you guys because you don't like Facebook or you don't care what somebody's eating for dinner or you don't like cat pictures on whether or not you need to use Facebook. Well, the rest of the world lives on Facebook about 50% of their day and watches more video on Facebook than they watch television in a single day. Yeah, we got to get there. So no different than I think people have been using smartphones for long enough that your website should be responsive by now. We got to get from behind the curve. Get in today's environment. Your customers are advancing faster than businesses are keeping up with. So those social media handles are really important because referral business is really important. If somebody goes to Google and they type in your company name, CI Web Group, for example, there's 41 million pages in this drawer. We own position number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is a social media site. This is a local listing. This is a social media site. This is a Google Business listing. This is Google Business, Google Plus account. This is social media. This is social media. This is social media. This is local listing. This is local listing. This is a website. This is a GoFundMe account. This is a YouTube social media website, local listing, directory, and so forth. So you notice I can keep going page after page after page after page. The more handles you own, the more listings you can own online. So the reason this is important, multiple reasons. One, when customers are looking for you, you do not want them to be confused on which link is yours. Some of you have picked out names that are company names that are as generic as my name, Jennifer. Okay, because they're generic, you can't figure out who you are. Totally not okay. We're going to have to work hard. Your first priority should be to make sure that if your customer, Mary, refers you to Joe and Joe goes and Googles your name, that he can instantly know who you are. Your local listing should be able to help you sell or help them sell that. So this is the next search they're going to do. They're going to look for your company first, and then they're going to look for the word reviews after it. So we've got to make sure that we are properly setting up your business so that you have reviews showing up on your site. I'll show you another example. Here's a client of ours. So for Sheldon's, somebody searched for Sheldon Service Reviews. His website owns position number 1, most professional. 2, his homepage. 3, Sheldon Save Us Big Bucks. And then you're going into the directories, Yelp, Yellow Pages, and all of that. Because I don't want to send a referral to a website that has 60 competitors on it in 2 seconds. I want them to just come to my site, read the review, make a decision, and move forward. So little things that are really important. Social media, you got to have great images, great content. People are lazy. They don't want to read a bunch of text. Make it pretty. Turn it into an image. That way you can use it forever and ever and ever. Post frequently and automate as much as you possibly can. Connect with customers, vendors, get your staff involved, tag friends, pages, respond, share, like, and so forth. I get it. There's a large percentage of you listening or watching this later that don't even want to use Facebook yourself. So here's what we have to do at a bare minimum. We have to make sure you don't look like you are not alive. So we have to make sure your business does not look like it is closed or has been out of business for the last 3 years, because the last time you post was in 2000 and blank, 5, 12, and so forth. All right. Oops. That was quick. So that being said, we've done keywords, promotions, graphics, social. Next thing is local. There is 60 local listings accounts. There's a top 50 list that you guys need to own and make sure your content is perfect. All the perfect addresses, same company name on all of them, same exact address that's on Google listings, same phone number, same everything, and they need to be optimized for your services. When you sign up with companies that do local listings, usually they're just going to put your address, your phone number, hopefully a logo, maybe a short description, but they're not SEO companies, so they're not going to optimize it. They're not marketing agencies, so they're not going to be worrying about what your promotions are and keeping all the local listings, all 50 different local listings. And when I say local listing, I mean Google Business is a local listing. Yelp, Yellow Pages, White Pages, YP, all of those are local listings. If you go out and pay all of them individually, you're going to be out thousands of dollars, tens of thousands over the year. All of them can be updated from one shot, $100, all 50 accounts, $100 a month, they can be updated, managed, optimized. And in addition to that, for an extra $100, all of your reviews can be monitored by a third-party company. This is what we do all day long. If you get a great review, we let you know about it. We send it to our social media guys. They design some pretty graphic, post on your social account, send it to the SEO team, and so forth. If it's a negative review, we're going to help you respond. Make sure that there's a response. If it's erroneous or an ex-employee, then we're going to try and help you dispute it. It's inexpensive. You got to get it done, and it absolutely impacts your link building. So in a nutshell, you guys, all I'm covering in this, no matter how big your headache is right now, is the basics. And I hate to say it, these are bare minimum. We got to get these things done. No excuses, no nothing. It's not expensive. It's not going to take a ton of your time. It has to happen. It's just reality. Once the basics done, we would be having strategy meetings on a quarterly basis to figure out how can we continue to make enhancements. And at some point, you will get to the point where you actually have a comprehensive marketing plan, and it's going to take some time because you probably have a lot that needs fixed out of the gate. During this, in order to make these enhancements, we have to measure everything. Don't have a pay-per-click plan going straight to your homepage, right? And all that data is mixed in with your SEO data, and you can't tell whether your pay-per-click dollar investment drove the new business or your SEO dollar investment drove the business. We have to measure everything at its root. We have to report on it, and based on that data, we have to be very, very dynamic and flexible. You never want to get into a hardcore plan that is, here's the package, it can't change, it's a two-year agreement, it's a one-year agreement. This has to be very dynamic. You should be staying with your agency because you love them, not because there is a contract and a ring on it. So we have, you know, when you attend these kind of trainings, and you guys don't just attend mine, you attend lots of trainings, you have to be very, very careful, because when you go to a training, you get excited and you're like, let's do it. And the challenge is you have to do the right things in the right order at the right time to be effective. Otherwise, you're always going to be trying the next thing, trying to figure out when you're ever going to see results. So these are fundamentals. Fundamentals first. So if you go to a training on Pinterest and you come back and you call me and you say, Jen, I just went to this great training. It's on Pinterest. I want to do Pinterest. I may say, no, not yet. So sometimes the answer, if you have someone that's being truthful and upfront with you, it's not that they're going to say no, but they should say, not right now. You have other things that need to happen first. You should not be investing in SEO if you have a website that's not responsive. You should not have an SEO agency say they're doing SEO if you have a website that can't be indexed by Google. You should not be investing in pay-per-click if you don't have a landing page to capture and measure those lead conversions. You should not be investing in Twitter if you don't have Facebook down. You shouldn't be investing in Pinterest if you don't have a perfect website designed for conversions, built properly, responsive, with a great SEO program, at least Facebook being covered, and your local listings are straight. We have to get the basics down. So I'm stressing this as much as I can. When it comes down to having a comprehensive plan and you're measuring your results, it should look something like this. A percentage of your new business is going to come from SEO. A percentage of your new business is going to be direct. That's referral business, repeat business. You guys are at a conference, a trade show, so forth. That may be actually in the other bucket, the trade show. Direct is they already know you, so that may be existing customers who already know your link. Other trade shows and so forth, social media, and then you should have a piece of it coming from pay-per-click. All of these combined is a comprehensive marketing plan. And, of course, we can add in other things into the other area. Technically, what everyone should be doing online looks something like this. Blow over it. Skip it. Let's just do the basics. That being said, absolutely take time. As soon as you get off of this webinar, get done watching it, go over to ciwebgroup.com. Bottom right-hand corner, there is a button. There's also a contact us button. There's a little calendar button. Click any of them, and it says schedule a consultation. Go there, set up an interview with us. I will do a personal strategy session with you and help you identify what are the first two, three, four things you need to do right now in order to be able to improve your results and be prepared for this summer. I don't want you guys to wait. If you wind up calling in May or June and saying, I need my phone to ring this summer, how do we do that? You're going to have a big pay-per-click budget to make that happen. So plan ahead. Let's get these things done. You need time to get your website changes fixed. You need time to get the infrastructure up. You need time to get the analysis done. Time to choose your key phrases. You're going to need to have content writers write all that content. And the SEO team optimize everything. You need time. So, again, it's January. You should be focused on this right now. Let's make sure you guys are sitting in the absolute perfect position to roll into this summer's cooling season. And let's get started now. You guys, this is not a sales pitch. I like this stuff because I'm analytical and we know it really, really well. So what you'll notice on these calls is it's meat and potatoes. We're going to get down and dirty and figure out exactly what you need to do, give you recommendations. If you choose to work with us or you're interested in that, awesome. We'd love to work with you. If you have another agency and you want to take everything that is said on our call and it'll be recorded so you'll get a copy of it and you want to take it back to your agency, absolutely. We just want you to be successful. That's the investment that Daikin and CI Web Group jointly have committed to is helping you become more successful. So with that, Catherine, it's all you.
Yes, ma'am. Just as a reminder, go ahead and submit any questions you have through your chat box. We'll be more than happy to answer them for you. And definitely take advantage of this offer. It's a great offer to take care of or take advantage of. Jennifer, when someone calls and they want to set up an appointment, first of all, what information should they have available for you? And second of all, is there kind of a rule of thumb about how that call goes?
Well, we actually
really, I'm sorry.
No, you're perfect. We do two calls. So the first call, you're actually meeting with someone on our team. It'll be a consultant. It'll be a consultant, and they will do an interview. They're going to ask you a ton of questions. They need to know what products you focus on. They need to know how do you sell. Are you guys focused on repair and service business in order to get installations? Are you focused on only installations? Are you high-dollar installations? So they're going to ask you a lot of just basic details about your business. I'm going to review all of that data, and the second meeting, it's down and dirty strategy. I'll have enough information to know what your goals are, how you sell, what you sell, how long you've been in business, the size of your business, how many techs, how many trucks, how many salespeople. I've got to understand the infrastructure of your company, and then I've got to understand your goals. Once I have that, I can take all the knowledge we have for marketing and apply it and be able to give you some actual good guidance, not just a general webinar that might be applicable to everybody or might not. But that's really what those two calls are. So you may spend total an hour and a half on the phone with us, and it's really just valuable time spent.
That's great. You know, of all the webinars we've done together, I guess I've missed that you record the calls too, so that somebody, I know I like to take notes, but it would be nice to be able to review that kind of recording later on and say, you know what, here's something I might not have heard the first time around. I can apply it, you know, when
yep.
I hear it again. So that's
every
really cool.
One of them is recorded.
Yeah, that's great. Okay, well, we have a quiet group today, which is fine. Just so you know, we do record these, speaking of recordings, a little bit later today. You will receive a follow-up email. In the body of the email, it will have the link to the recorded version, so if you'd like to review it or perhaps share it with somebody you know, you're welcome to do that. If you do think of any questions, feel free to submit them. You can either reach me at the Goodman Partners Network or Daikin Webinars at Daikin Comfort email address, or you can reach Jennifer. Her contact information is right on your screen. Also, I want to mention there is a post-webinar survey. Feel free to let us know how we did. We always look at that feedback and try to, you know, see what we're doing well and what we can improve. So appreciate it. Jennifer, as always, great information. Appreciate your time. Anything you wanted to say in closing?
Just thanks for everybody taking a moment out of your business to work on your business instead of in your business. We appreciate you.
Thanks so much. Everybody, thank you very much for joining us. This does conclude our webinar. I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day. Thanks very much. Bye-bye.